Hi guys, assalamu alaikum. This is Arif. In this video we are going to see how we can use queue, stack, dequeue and linked list in C++ first and then in C#. In the case of there are actually queue, stack and dequeue only, and in the case of C# it is queue, stack and linked lists. So this is a C++ program first. Here in this line we are going to take the contents of an input file using ifstream and display and store those contents onto the console window and into an output file through ofstream. Then we have defined a list which we are going to convert into queue, stack and dequeue later. And here we are using this pushback function and we are going to take the contents of our input file, store those into our string, and then we are going to store that string using this pushback function into our list which we have defined here. So then we are going to run this while loop on this list like this. And we are not only showing those contents onto the console window through cout, but also we are going to store those contents into an output file as well. And finally, we are going to close our input and output file as well. So this is the complete program. So now let's see how we can use the stack on this program instead of the list. The queue first. So in order to do that, we are going to include this queue library. Then we can comment out this. Right now we had defined the list. And now we are going to define the elements to the queue. And now our elements instead of list, it is queue. So we are going to use the push function instead of push back function. Now, in order to iterate through, we can't use this like this to display those and store those elements. So we have to skip these lines. Actually, instead of skipping this, we can skip all this. So the iterator we can't use on the queues. So instead we have to define a while loop like this. So this is our while loop. So what we are doing here is we are using the front function on our queue. And then after that, we are using this pop function to delete the same element from the queue. So while the queue is not empty, we have defined the while loop like this, that it should go through all the queue. And the front element it is going to display and then it is going to store, and then the same front element it is going to delete, then it is going to go to the next element and it is going to display that next element, store that, and then it is going to, through the pop function, it is going to delete this, and this is where it is going to go through all the queue. So queue is first input, first output. So it is getting the first line as input and it is going to display the first line as the output, and then it is going to go to the second line and it is going to display that. So this is our input lines and this is what we are getting the output. First line first and then the second line. So this is queue, first input, first output. It is called FIFO as well. So now we can try this tag, which is the last in first out. And we have to define these elements as a stack instead of the queue. This function would stay same, the push function. And once we are going to run through a for loop to display those elements of the stack and store those, we are going to use this top function instead of the front function. So top function means whatever is on the top of the stack. So let's, and then the top element which we are going to use here, we are going to delete that as well, and we are going to make all the stack empty. So we see the first element, the last element is at the top, and the first element is at the bottom. So this is last in, first out. So the last in was this one, so first out is this one, and this is the first one, so this would be the last. So now we can see DQ, how we can implement this. And in the case of DQ, we have to use the pushback like the way we use in the list, not the push function. And now what here we can do is we can use this top function and the pop function, which we are using in the case of stack and queue. So now we can use the pop front function for the DQ to go through all the elements and display those. Actually, I forgot to include these lines. Yes. So the front function is going to give us the first value of our DQ, and this front function is going to store those values into the output file. So now let's run this. So this is the way our DQ is going to work. So in the case of queue and DQ, the difference is only in the case of queue, we are going to use the pop function. In the case of DQ, we are going to use the pop front function. And this function would be the same. So now in the case of DQ, actually what we can do here is we have another option. Instead of using this loop, we can use this loop as well, which we were not able to use in the case of stack and queue. But in the case of DQ, we can iterate through our elements like this as well in order to store those and display those. Just like the list. And actually, if we want to use the list as well, there is another way. So instead of DQ, if we define our elements like list, and now instead of using this loop, if we want to iterate through the elements like this, we can also do that. So let's use this loop. And it is going to work as well. So these were some features of queue, DQ, and the stack. And now let's flip over to our C# program and see what options are available there. So this is our simple program, which is going to take the contents of our input file using stream reader. It is going to store those contents into an output file using stream writer. Here we have defined a list, which we are going to change to implement the queue, stack, and linked list. And here we have defined a string line, and we are using this string on this add function to store all the lines of our input file into the elements list using this for loop. And here we are going to use this while loop to display those elements onto the console window using this line, and to store those elements into an output file using this line. And here we are going to close our input and output file as well. So this is our complete program. So let's run this program. So this is the input file lines which we are going to get onto the console window. This is our input file actually. Now let's see how we can use, in the case of C sharp, queue. Stack. And linked list. So this is the queue. Now we have defined the same variable elements with a queue string rather than a link, rather than a list. So now we can't use this add function. We have to use this enqueue function to store those elements, the input lines into our queue. And then we can use this while loop as well. So now we have used this while loop. So instead of this while loop, we can use this while loop as well. So comment out these. Instead of iterating through like this, we can use this as well. So we can see our output. So here we are using, actually we are saying that unless the elements count is not equal to 0. So what we are doing here is we are saying that use this peak function to show us our top value in our queue and then dequeue that value from our queue. So it is going to remove this and then it is going to run through until the all the count is going gone is equal to 0. So now on the same way, actually we can use the stack as well. So queue is first input, first output. The stack is last in, first out. So if we are going to define our elements through a stack, we have to change this thing. So in order to store the elements, first we have to use this push function instead of enqueue function for stack. And then here we can use the same peak function to get the first element of our stack. But in order to remove that element, we have to use this function, pop function. The rest of the program would stay same. So now in the case of stack, we can see the difference between queue and stack. This is the last in, first out. And this is the first in, so this is last out. So it is the exact opposite of queue. And in the case of stack, actually, we can use this loop as well to iterate through, which I am not going to show. But instead of using this loop, we can use this loop as well to iterate through and get all those elements as output. So now let's skip this line and let's define our elements variable as a linked list. So now let's see what is the linked list. So in the case of linked list, so this is the add first function we are going to use, and we are going to see how this is going to affect and how it is going to store those input lines into our linked list, which is of type string we have defined. And now we can't use this peak function. So instead, in the case of linked list, in order to display those contents onto the console window and also to store those values into the output file, we are going to use this first function on our linked list, which is named elements. And then on that first function, we are going to use the value. So this function is going to give us the value, the first value of this elements. So if we are not going to use this value function on this first function, then we are not going to get our value actually. But these two functions combined are going to give us the first value of our linked list. And then it is going to remove that first string. And then until the count becomes zero, it is going to go through all those elements. So now let's build and run this program. So now the way we are seeing here, we are going to see the last element first and the first element at the last. So why it is behaving like this is we have to scroll up and we are going to see here. So here we are using the add first function. So this is the reason why we are getting the first line at the last line at the top and the first line at the bottom. But if we are going to use this last add last function to add the strings lines into our linked list, and build and run this. So now we are going to see the first line coming out first and the second line coming out last. So this is the way the linked list is behaving. Now instead of using this while loop for all these linked list tag queue, we can use this loop as well. So right now I have defined the elements string as a linked list. So if I am going to iterate through all those elements using this while loop, so I am going to get it like this. So thank you guys. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Have fun.